There's a lot. Probably the most exciting is the growth we're seeing in customer signups. We launched a lot of our products under a freemium model, which makes it quicker and easier for the customer to jump in, try them, get value out of them, and then convert to a paid subscriber later in the journey. So, you know, since we made those changes, it's just really accelerated our customer growth. The other thing I'm always excited about is product. You know, just the products we're building and the team and the things we're going to be launching soon really do help a lot of businesses out there run better, more efficient, with less risk. So excited about the upcoming product releases too. Probably, you know, people are familiar with ESG and, you know, companies operating more transparently with better governance and reporting on what are they doing with the environment, what are they doing on social, and what about governance. ESG assets under management, that are forecast to be about $53 trillion in the next few years. So there's a huge tidal wave or tailwind coming down on the companies that can demonstrate they're doing ESG, doing it well, and they're operationalized that, and they've activated it in their company. They will get better investors, they will attract customers better, they will attract talent who want to work for companies that are very purpose-driven and can prove it. So the ESG momentum is probably the biggest tailwind for our business. Yeah, well, you know, doing more of what we've been doing is working, but, you know, we have a strategy where there's a lot of value locked in our products that are made up from several features. So for instance, like when someone's going to do an M&A deal and disclose all their sensitive information to their closest competitor, they want a lot of control over that, like a lot of rights management on security, tracking, dynamically watermarking all the information, knowing who's opened things, printed things, viewed things. So we have all that, but it's more contained in a product. But what we've realized and started doing is we're turning each one of those features into a solution module. So then, you know, anyone can sign up and use the value of those features in their business. Like, could be for secure file sharing, it could be they want to redact a document, all of this. So the modularization of our product into individual features, offering that for freemium to people, that's how we're going to scale a lot. And we've started doing that and seen success with it, because, you know, we've got over 500,000 users in our product. So there's huge opportunity if we can offer more solutions to those individual users under the module strategy. Yeah, that would be annual recurring revenue or ARR. So we, you know, over the years we've been transitioning our business into more and more recurring products, more and more recurring revenue. And similar to my previous answer, unlocking the value in our customer base. So how many of those users that we're connected to, how many of them can we get onto ARR solution modules? So, you know, the freemium strategy is part of that, to make it easy for them to sign up, no risk, no fuss, get value straight away out of that feature, and then they can convert into pay. So ARR and getting ARR out of our user base faster. I think the thing is a similar answer, like the more of those modules that we get off the production line and out in the marketplace, back them up with a digital freemium model, that's just gathering more and more momentum. We're working very hard on an ESG solution for the middle market. If you go to a CEO and CFO and say, look, what are you doing on ESG? Are you measuring that? Is it activated in your company? Can we see where it's at? Do you report on it? They don't. They just don't. Like, they're stuck. And if you jump into Google, it's just very confusing. So we're going to bring a very simple solution to the market that allows people to do all of that. And when we do that, I think it's a tremendous catalyst.